Determine the domain and range of the given functions. Use interval notation. First, we have the graph of y equals 1 divided by x. Notice the graph has a vertical asymptote at x equals 0, which affects the domain. The graph also has a horizontal asymptote of y equals 0. The domain is a set of all inputs or x values. The range is a set of all outputs or y values. To determine the range, we analyze the graph horizontally or from left to right. Notice the graph moves indefinitely to the left without any holes or breaks, and x approaches negative infinity. If we do have a break at x equals 0, then the graph moves to the right indefinitely, and x approaches positive infinity. So the only break in the graph is at x equals 0, which indicates the domain is all real numbers except x equals 0. If we were to graph this interval on the x-axis, we'd have an open point at x equals 0, an arrow to the right, and an arrow to the left. Expressing this interval using interval notation, the domain is the open interval from negative infinity to 0 union the open interval from 0 to infinity. And now to determine the range, we analyze the graph vertically or from the bottom to the top. Notice the graph goes down indefinitely and y approaches negative infinity. We do have a break in the graph at y equals 0, and the graph moves up indefinitely and y approaches positive infinity. This indicates the range is all real numbers except y equals 0, which if we were to graph on the y-axis, we'd have an open point at y equals 0, an arrow going down, and an arrow going up. Using interval notation, the range is the same interval as a domain. We have the open interval from negative infinity to 0 union the open interval from 0 to infinity. And now let's take a look at the second graph. Notice now we have a vertical asymptote at x equals negative 2, which is where if we look at the function is when we have division by 0, and there's also a horizontal asymptote at y equals negative 3. Again, to determine the domain, we analyze the graph from left to right or horizontally. Notice the graph moves to the left indefinitely, and x approaches negative infinity. And to the right, the graph approaches positive infinity. The only break is at x equals negative 2, which means now the range is all real numbers except x equals negative 2, which if we were to graph on the x-axis, we would have an open point at x equals negative 2, an arrow to the left, and an arrow to the right. Using interval notation, the domain is the open interval from negative infinity to negative 2 union the open interval from negative 2 to infinity. And now to find the range, we analyze the graph vertically or from the bottom to the top. And notice the graph goes down indefinitely and y approaches negative infinity. The graph goes up indefinitely and y approaches positive infinity. But now we have a break in the graph at y equals negative 3, which indicates the range is all real numbers except y equals negative 3, which if we were to graph on the y-axis, we'd have an open point at y equals negative 3, arrow going down, arrow going up. Using interval notation, the range is the open interval from negative infinity to negative 3 union the open interval from negative 3 to infinity. I hope you found this helpful.